Welcome back to the Katherine Thomas Podcast. Time and presence are the greatest gifts we can give. Thank you so much for sharing those with me today. My goals for our time spent together today are threefold: reframing, recharging, and reemerging. Reframing, referring to observing life through a different lens and finding the extraordinary in the ordinary. Recharging, referring to resetting mind and heart to a place of calmness, compassion, and curiosity. And reemerging, referring to leaving today's conversation inspired to make a difference in the world through small and simple actions. The title of today's conversation is Falling into Change. As summer transitions into fall, I observe myself moving from the outer world to my inner one for a period of quietude and reflection. As the trees go through their seasonal metamorphosis, so can we. My poem, Autumn's Lesson, touches on this subject. Autumn's Lesson. Singular leaves initiate the process of transformation before the entire tree is set afire. This fall, I observed a difference in how the leaves changed from previous years. At first, I was dismayed that this year's display was not as dynamic as it had been previously. After a bit of reflection, however, it occurred to me that although the change in foliage was less dynamic, change still had occurred. Some trees completely change color. Takeaway: sometimes change occurs all at once, in an obvious manner. Some trees only partially changed, resulting in some leaves remaining unchanged while being surrounded by others that had transformed. Takeaway: change is not dependent on our surroundings and others taking the same action. Some trees showed no change. Takeaway: sometimes holding on to what is the best that can be done at the time. Some trees appear to be unchanged, but on closer examination, individual leaves showed unique patterns of change. Takeaway: sometimes change can occur quietly and not be readily apparent, but it has nevertheless taken place. Human behavior mirrors that of the trees. Change is not an all or nothing thing. Sometimes we just need to look a little more closely to see it. Change can be boldly obvious or quietly assuming. Obvious displays of change include career and relationship transitions, moving, loss of loved ones, serious illness, and spiritual quests. Quieter displays of change can include habit stacking, changing diet and fitness routines, or curbing use of social media. Some leaves, even when surrounded by neighbors resistant to change, make the bold and unilateral decision to transform themselves. Think about this. If individual leaves dare to express themselves authentically in a setting where doing so isn't the norm, shouldn't we extend that similar compassion to ourselves? What holds us back from making change is fear. Fear encourages us to remain in our comfort zones. Although change can bring many benefits to our lives, fear compels us to freeze and to cling to the perceived safety of the familiar. Fighting through the fear of making change has greatly benefited my life over the last several years. In early 2020, I experienced the convergence of a milestone birthday, the ending of my 30-year relationship, and onset of COVID. The blurb on the back of my book, Awakening the Vulnerable Heart, states my life-changing epiphany. If you had to say that you were living your most authentic life, could you? When that realization came, I felt like a marionette that had suddenly had its strings pulled and was brought to life. I knew the time to act was now. Becoming awakened to the fact that a major life change needed to be made felt very daunting. I liken my situation to being on a crumbling bluff with the only way off being a tightrope without a safety net. My choices were to go down with the bluff or take the risk of coming to a place of contentment by initiating change. Both choices, ignoring my new truth, remaining on the bluff, or setting out to live authentically, had risks and rewards. Because so many factors would be unknown until actually getting on the tightrope, the decision to take a leap of faith was a huge step out of my comfort zone. My poem, High Dive, illustrates this quandary. High Dive. Jumping off the high dive is daunting. Moving forward requires hitting bottom and having faith in resurfacing. Backing away means hovering blindly over a safety net of concrete. Breathe, focus, release. In order to pursue change, we must first learn to trust ourselves. During the time I was faced with making my life-altering change, two quotes inspired me. The first one is by Anais Nin. And the day came when the risk to remain tight in a bud was more painful than the risk it took to blossom. The second quote is by C.G. Martin. It's better to cross the line and suffer the consequences than just stare at that line for the rest of your life. The fable of the eagle and chicken also beautifully illustrates the journey of making changes to align with true self. Once upon a time, an eagle fell from its nest. A farmer discovered it and brought it to a farm where it was nurtured by chickens. Unaware of its true nature, it did as the chickens around it did. Although it thrived, it was without knowledge of its true nature and awareness of what it could be. A zookeeper heard of the eagle being raised as a chicken and visited the farm. The farmer defended the eagle as being a chicken because that was what it knew and was raised to be. The zookeeper knew that it was capable of more. Multiple times, the zookeeper took the eagle to different locales, telling it to fly. Each time, the eagle refused to do so, returning to its chicken family and their ways. The zookeeper was saddened but refused to give up on the eagle and was determined to prove its magnificence to it. The next day, the zookeeper took the eagle to the top of a mountain, telling it that it belonged to the heavens rather than the earth, and told it to fly. Unlike the previous times, the eagle took pause, truly heard the zookeeper's words, became enlightened to its true nature, and soared off towards the sun. After that epiphany, it never returned to its previous life that was the wrong fit. Sometimes, we independently assume that we are chickens versus eagles. We make this assumption to fit in our established groups and adhere to societal norms. That familiar environment has always been labeled chicken, so we go along with that. Sometimes, others tell us that we're chickens. They call us chickens because that is the way they frame the world and within their comfort level. By labeling us in a way that keeps them comfortable, the us versus them mindset is upheld, keeping us part of the established group. Sometimes we start out contentedly as chickens but evolve into eagles. Making a life change can cause us to question our status as chickens. When we declare ourselves to be eagles and present ourselves as such, others may become uncomfortable. By declaring ourselves no longer chickens, we move from us to them. By renouncing our chicken status, a mirror is then held up to them. Do they still identify as chickens? Or do they, as well, need to institute change? What are their choices? They can contentedly remain chickens. They can know that they too are eagles but resist the change needed, or they can set out to make life changes to reclaim their eagle status. Once we've become eagles and those around us make their team chicken or team eagle loyalties known, the playing field can and will change. Motivational speaker Jim Rohn proposed the theory that we are the average of the five people we spend the most time with. These individuals serve to inspire, impact, and drive our behaviors. In order to be surrounded by the right five people, however, we first must need to know ourselves. When you change yourself, your sphere of influence also changes. The people who once served you may no longer be the right fit. The question is, who serves the true self that you are now? Once you become comfortable in your new self and live within it, you need to set new boundaries around that true self. When we show up in familiar and predictable ways, it validates the expectations of others and keeps them comfortable. We must prepare ourselves to be unsurprised when those changes might be met with resistance rather than acceptance. Finally, the choice of whether to weather the changes needed to live authentically or remain on the path of least resistance is ours. Again, I want to thank you so much for tuning into the Catherine Thomas podcast today. If you found today's episode, I'd love it if you'd share it. My book of poetry and photography, Awakening the Vulnerable Heart, is available on Amazon. Until we meet again, may you find beauty.